Hello, this is Curtis Crow, the Photo Pro, here with Photo News. Our first item for today is Filipina maid captures dreams through photography. This article was pretty interesting. The premise or basic story behind it is that there was this very, very poor woman in the Philippines who moved to China, Hong Kong, in order to become a maid. So she was in a very small village, not a lot of money, so she figured why not, basically. And after being out there for years, she got an opportunity to shoot with a Nikon D90. And she started capturing photos. And at first, it was just to share with Facebook friends and stuff like that. But eventually, became much more. She started showing her art at different galleries. And now she's doing much better for herself. It's a very interesting article to see how you can go from starting with nothing to becoming something with very limited resources. Go ahead and read the article. Let me know what you think down in the comment section below. You'll find the article right here. And for our second item of the day, do you remember your old Instagram photos? You know, right when Instagram came out with their fancy new filters and their beautiful borders. Well, they've evolved a lot since then. And this article is about going back and reviewing your first Instagram photo and seeing exactly how it looked, what borders you had, what filter, how the filters look, and tell me what you think of that first photo. It's a great way to critique, and it got me thinking that, you know, maybe I should go back to some of my first photos and see how far I've come along since then. Heck, maybe there were some things I was trying back then that might even be inspirational for now, things that I've overlooked, things that I've outgrown, but could go back and either perfect or bring forward and improve on. So just something to think about. Articles right here. I'll let you go ahead and read that. It's real quick. And for our final item, we have an article out of DP Review. B-Grip launches Uniholster for compact system cameras. Now, I thought this was pretty cool because I know some of you people out there, you very unique and special people, use compact cameras. You guys are ahead of the times. You guys are like, I don't need a DSLR and all their beautiful settings and picture quality. I'm going to go latest and greatest, compact, fast shutter speeds. I'm not harping on you. Actually, I think it's a great idea. The camera's just a tool. It really is. And you can get awesome photos with a compact system. So what they are doing is they're launching a holster. So you just carry it on your hip. It's a small item. So it won't be that burdensome. Put it right on your hip. It'll be a good place for it, unless you're in compact situations, of course, because you don't want to bump your compact camera and break off one of those fancy little dials you probably have on it. But it was something I thought was interesting, something that if you are a compact camera owner, you'd probably want to check out. If you'd like to check that out, that's right up here. And that's it for me today. This has been Curtis Crow, the Photo Pro, and you've just gotten some photo news. And as I always do, toodles.